And right now, over to you, madam, right now.
Okay, sir. Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Today was set the BGMC block for media and cultural studies. First of all, basically, we people will understand the what is culture. We all knew that journalism is a subject which relates to different disciplines. Culture is one of them. Okay. The word culture derives from the Latin word colere, which means to reach to the earth and grow or cultivation and nature. Culture is a densely packed and far-reaching term with multiple levels of meanings. It is a widely used concept. It includes knowledge, belief, art, morals, law, customs, and any other capabilities and habits acquired by individuals as a member of society. Our culture always teaches us significant roles, rituals, and procedures. It influences the social behavior, the lifestyle, and the habits and practices of us. We can compare the old tradition with the new one, how it changes with the time. Culture is always changeable. Okay? We people will always understand the how our culture changes with the time and how the culture always mutually influence our communication system also. The culture means a sign of the original life of us. Okay, then the culture normally a very good thing. The culture means amara sanskruti. Sanskruti kahile tame mane kon bujhucha? Then sanskruti hochi amara gyana, ame kon bishwas karuchu, amara moral value, amara law, amara custom, sabu jinsa hochi amara sanskruti bhitare ase. Ame jodi dekhiba je culture is also pervasive in nature. How the culture is pervasive in nature? Anywhere it can enter. Culture always entered in anywhere, may be welcome or not, but it enters everywhere. It affects all aspects of life, the need, the belief, the taste of the people, though all these are not homogeneous. Okay? When we belong to a culture, we are pervaded by the tradition, the convention of that culture, like using particular language, style, manner, food, etc. Okay, now we'll discuss the characteristics of culture. What is the characteristics of culture? First one is culture is holistic. Holistic means all total things. Okay, the culture is not separable to other things. Edward Hall, one of the cultural strategists, he basically said that you touch a culture in one place and everything else is affected. It means tame jodi gote jagare culture ko chhuncha, it must be affected. The culture affect the other things. Like you can take also an example, like जेतेबेले तमे माने गोटे कल्चर रे माने गोटे जिंस को छुईबा को जाउछ गोटे जिंस करिया को जाउछ सेटा अलगा जिंस को तमारा अफेक्ट करूची देन से भलिया कल्चर इज लर्न. कल्चर इज लर्न मींस कल्चर इज नॉट इनबॉर्न, इट इज नॉट बायोलॉजिकल. ओके, यू कैन टेक आल्सो एग्जांपल्स. सम टाइम्स आवर पेरेंट्स टोल्ड अस डोंट डू लाइक दैट, these are bad things, etc., etc. But when we people are the child, at that time we always try to imitate the people, always follow the people, not follow their words. So culture is learned. Sometimes ame bi kahu bele bele jemiti kemiti pila se emiti byabahar karuchi sei bhulia family ru belong karuchi ta culture seya sethi pai ame kahu je culture is always a learned factor. Okay, then culture is dynamic. Culture is dynamic means culture is always changeable every time. It is not fixed or static. Okay? You, if you people basically went through before 10 years, at that time, your culture is very different from the from nowadays. Okay? So culture is dynamic always. The culture is also ethnocentric. Ethnocentric means the culture is always, some people are always said like that, we are the superior one. Ethnocentric means the tendency to judge all other groups according to your own group standard, behaviors and customs, and making such comparisons. People too often decide that their group is superior. My culture is superior than yours. The concept, the culture is ethnocentric means always think yourself the superior one. No, that is not good, but it is the characteristics of a culture. Okay, then subcultures. What is subculture? Subculture is a microculture, a part of culture, a lesser part of the culture of a dominant largest culture. Okay, subculture can be categorized in different numbers of indicators like gender, ethnicity, profession, social class, organization, graphic regions, all these things. First, we go through ethnic culture. What is ethnic culture? It is a very indigenous culture. Ethnic groups or ethnic cultures are basically very limited groups, and they have their own, they don't want to out from their belief, their stereotypes, their myths, etc. Okay, then we can also take examples of your Kandhas, Kolhas, and their concept, etc. The people basically try to live in their indigenous culture with their ethnicity. Okay, then the organizational culture. Organizational culture is also another important part of a subculture. Another point of subculture. Organization culture. Organization means any organization. Your dressing habit, your manners, your behaviors, your traits, etc. All these things, your uniforms, your how you basically behave with your superiors, all these are basically organizational cultures. And also how people basically coordinate with the other employees, and how you basically communicate with the subordinates, all these things are also different types of organizational culture. I think you people are so trying to understand my words. Okay, then original cultures. Regional cultures basically it basically based upon the geographic regions. Geographic regions means different cultural groups are staying in different regions. They have their social attitudes, social lifestyles, social food preferences, and social communication systems. The rural peoples, the people came from the rural area, their culture are basically different from the urban people. Okay, then we'll go to the levels of culture in traditional society. What is the culture of traditional society? The original cultural expression was dominated by the folk and popular art, which were originated and enjoyed by the majority of people living under the strong influence of traditional nations in a superior society. Okay? The folk culture and the popular art. Folk culture means the art of the people, the people's culture. Normally, it basically the folk art means loko katha. Lokomananko pai jo jinso heithila, lokomananko base karke jo jinso kara jaithila. The traditional folk or popular culture was not as elaborate as the creation of great art and literature, but their concept basically relates to the relates to our life. So we people, I think the folk culture is a better culture. And before, in our old days, the folk culture is basically the culture of the rural people. Now it is also a popular culture at that time. Now it is also popular, but after the entrance of the mass culture, I think somehow it basically lost its glowingness. Okay, then we will describe about it after in the second unit. Okay, then the mass society. What is the mass society? Mass society is an industrial society. The modern industrial techniques to the creation of an elaborate network of transportation and communication bring the various parts of mass society in frequent contacts. The mass of population has become incorporated into the society. Mass society, meaning mass society, tama ko kaha ko kahujo. To tame jemi dekhiba je total mass ku jodi nei ki ame amaro society tak amaro tiyari hoji. The mass society is continuous common territory. The beyond all division of kids, any relationship tomorrow beyond amit what a society is to roho any beyond the caste, beyond the religion, beyond the relationship, when a society form a mass, basically that society is called as the mass society. Okay, and a mass society involves large masses of people. A mass society involves large masses of people, numbering even into the hundreds of millions. Okay, then the mass society is strongly influenced by powerful bureaucratic organization. The social structure of a mass society is equilateral in theory, if not in the practice. It is heterogeneous in religion, ethnic background, style of life, and access to position of power. The mass society have also different characteristics. Mass society is secular. Its members having less veneration for tradition than to the members of older society. A mass society has undergone a complex technological development, all these things. Then the levels of culture in modern society. What is the culture in a modern society? Normally the society, the culture in the modern society divided into three parts. One is hydroculture, the second one is the middle bro culture, and the third one is the low bro culture. What is hydroculture? Hydroculture is the culture of the elite classes and the aristocrats. Okay, then the hydroculture basically based upon the classical things. The high and the culture also contain the high aesthetic value and superior. It also need the superior literary standard. Okay, the basically the high bro culture are not understandable by a mass. A little bit understandable by the mass. Okay, then the great work of poetry, novel, philosophy, scientific theories. Research, paintings, serious music, composition, like classical music, their performance, all these things. Okay, then the middle bro culture. What is the middle bro culture? The middle bro culture, normally the culture of the middle bro culture is normally the culture of the middle classes. Okay, the culture basically, the middle bro culture basically, the middle bro culture basically influenced by the high bro culture and also by the low bro culture. The members of middle class families, a handful of persons in rural areas and quite large in numbers in urban locations. The principal consumers of mediocre culture means the average culture, the middle class culture, but middle bro culture basically the average culture. Okay, the middle bro cultural products are normally the mixed culture of the high bro culture and the low bro culture. The mixed culture means people basically influenced by the both the culture, like your classical, the high standard poetry, the aesthetic value, and the low standard, the mass culture, like these, all these things. Okay, then what is the lowbrow culture? The lowbrow culture is the brutal culture. It designated as brutal culture by Edward Sears. Okay, the industrial working class and the rural population together consume mostly the mass media transmitted brutal or lowbrow culture, remarks Edward Sears. Edward Sears, a communication strategist, I think, basically said that the culture is based upon the culture of industrial working class and the rural population. For their consumption, the lowbrow culture was developed. Okay, like, what are the different examples of lowbrow cultures? The different examples are crime films, television spectacles, paperbacks, and violence, pornographic literature, and culture of the world of sports, like, etc. Okay, then I think you people will understand. Then the communication and culture. And what is communication and what is culture? They are inseparable in nature. What is culture? I already discussed and I already told about what is culture and what is communication now. The communication, you all people, as the journalism student, you already have known that and knew that the what is communication and the communication basically how impact the life of one us. Like the culture is the base and communication is a part of it, okay? And they are mutually influences to each other, okay? The communication and culture, how communication and culture, they are related to each other, and the communication is always shape the culture, and through the communication, the culture spread to the masses, okay? Then communication and culture are inseparable. Culture is a code we learn and share, and learning and sharing equal communication, culture and communication, therefore mutually influence one another. The culture and communication mutually influence one another. Producing different behavioral patterns in different contexts, the culture influences how we adopt and learn our perception of reality, language pattern, habits, customs, expectations, norms, and roles. In other words, it says what we do, how we look, what we say, and how we say. Communication and culture are inseparable. Okay? Then, the complex link. The culture and communication can be illustrated in a number of ways. Okay? They also have the complex link, the intricate link. In the first place, culture teaches us significant rules, rituals, and procedures, such as our orientation towards time, the perceived degree of power distance, our tolerance of uncertainty, how to dress, when and what to eat, and how to walk, all these things. Okay? Like, then communication, basically, through the communication style, avoids a direct confrontation and using face, and replace the values of harmony, non-competitiveness, and loyalty to superiors in Asian culture, all these things. Okay? The culture teaches us how to develop relationship with others, and communication also, the communication behaviors are very considerably across through the also in impact the decision of us, like the buying clothes from a market stall in the foreign and prepare to engage in intensive bargaining, etc., etc., like this. Then the interactive model. The communication involves people, message channel, encoding, decoding, feedback, noise, etc. People are the sources and receiver of the message. Communication occurs in a particular content which potentially affects every element of the communication process. Communication is the vehicle by which people intimate, maintain, and terminate their relationship with others. Okay. Also, you can see here the Scrum's interactive model of communication, the message. I think there is some printing mistake, like encounter. There is also written as encounter. I think this is encoder, the interpreter, decoder, and here is also decoder, interpreter, and encoder. The interpreter basically encode the message and the decode the message, and also the interpreter here also encode the message and decode the message and also give the feedback. The Scrum's interactive model of communication suggests that. Okay, I think if people will understand, then the cultural linkage, the culture, communication and culture are closely bound together. Okay, all communications engaged in by human beings are culturally linked. And all of us are cultural communicators. Yes, we all people are cultural communicators. We basically, when we people basically meet with the other people at that time, we people sometimes we also does their feet and also wish them and also try to communicate with them. How are you? Are you fine? If we people met first time, then we also talk like that. Where are you from? Are you graduate in science? Okay, and you are very beautiful and very well looking, very nice. Like this type of these things, we basically try to communicate with each other, because the human being are always, I mean, the social animal, and the social animals are always staying in the society, and they can't stay without the communication, I think. Then the great human documents, the cultural norms, values are developed by human documents like our Vedas, Upanishads, the Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana, the Quran, Bible, etc. Like these, all these things. And the lifespan of the human race, I think the lifespan of the human race would be seriously short without these great documents. We learn very deep moral value from these great human documents. I think now people at the time of COVID-19, Corona, and the lockdown time, the government basically decided to rebroadcasted the Ramayana and Mahabharata. And I think more and more people who have not seen all these things at the time, now the people are basically learn the huge things, basically is moral value from that things, and that will help them. I think that will help them for their future. Despite the okay, all these things, then we are very in a hurry mode, then because we have a limited period of time. Okay, the shared symbolic environment at the time of communication, we people basically not just sending the message, we also share the facts, ideas, opinion, and emotions. Also share the symbols verbally, non-verbally, in a written way, in the audio-visual way, we also share our views with others, the symbols with others, etc. And another important point, we live in communication, very interesting and important point, like we live in communication. Yes, the traditional concept of communication, we people, we already read different types of definition of communication, and the exchange of exchange the ideas, share the ideas, the information, etc., etc. But we live in communication. Yes, we people basically live in communication. The sharing between the speaker and the audience. Okay, we live in communication means in the age of communication is that revolution. Communication is far more important central for human condition than ever before realized. Now we people basically raised in the digital era, the technology advances, the communication system advances, then globalization also happened. Then we all people are basically across our boundaries with the communication. And also the information come towards us, cross to the national boundaries of different countries. Okay. Then communication is also a perspective at the time of communication culture. Always we people basically take the name of communication, because if you people think that in before your year in the some years ago at the time, the communication basically the culture basically not spreading. Nowadays, the culture basically spread. So communication is most essential, is a very most essential thing for us. Intercultural sensitivity means intercultural, different cultures and meet or basically communicate with each other through the way of communication. The different cultures are met with each other. Okay, now basically we people are going, money went to different countries. They also came to our countries. We also basically import the contents from the media conglomerates, and they also get the news, when they got the news from us like this, etc. And our people are basically staying there. They also came here to stay here for anything, any for their job, for tourism, etc., etc. But through this, we people basically exchange our cultures. I think it is also intercultural sensitivity. Then the people, I think I complete the first unit, then we people will discuss about the second unit. What is the popular culture? I think so many cultural strategists, they basically refer as the mass culture is the popular culture, the culture of the mass, Gono Sanskriti. ହଉଛି ଲୋକପ୍ରିୟ ସଂସ୍କୃତି। ହଁ, ଲୋକମାନେ ବହୁତ ଲୋକ ଯୋଉଠି ଯୋଉ ଜିନିଷକୁ ଗ୍ରହଣ କରନ୍ତି, ଯୋଉ ଜିନିଷ ସାଙ୍ଗରେ କଣ୍ଟାକ୍ଟ ରହନ୍ତି, ଯୋଉ ଲୋକମାନେ ତାକୁ ଆଡପ୍ଟ କରି ନିଅନ୍ତି, ସ୍ୱାଭାବିକ ଭାବରେ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ପପୁଲାର କଲଚର ବୋଲି କହୁ। ଯେହେତୁ ଏଟା ମାସ୍ କଲଚର ବୋଲି ଆମେ କହୁଛେ, ସେଥିପାଇଁ ପପୁଲାର କଲଚର ବୋଲି କହୁଛେ। ହ୍ୱାଟ ଇଜ୍ ପପୁଲାର କଲଚର? ଦ ପପୁଲାର କଲଚର ଇଜ୍ ଦ ସେଟ୍ ଅଫ ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିସେସ, beliefs and objects that embody the most broadly shared meaning of social system. It includes the media objects, entertainment, leisure, fashion, trends, linguistic convention, etc. Okay, I think the mass culture, as I will discuss the mass culture as popular culture. Mass culture is often referred to by various authors as the popular culture. The popular culture flourishes, exists, and transmitted by the mass media in the form of classical art, in the form of true folk art, in the form of the like and dislike of the audience, because we people, now the mass media producers are basically in very in, many interested to send the message to the sorry, sorry, send the message to the audience according to their choice. So then the mass culture is the popular entertainment. Yes, the mass culture is the popular entertainer. The through television, radio, the cinema, popular novels, newspaper, magazines, social media, the communicate basically the culture spread through in different areas, through different society, through different parts of the world. Okay, the cultural debate. The culture debate is mostly centered around the effect of mass communication on the culture in highly industrialized countries, like the United States, Japan, Germany, England, and such other countries. In those countries, basically, the people basically sometimes make debate in the culture. What is culture? How the culture basically impact the society? And after the globalization, how the culture basically reached in every area, and how it is impacted? The culture may be, the real culture may be vanished or not, and how the culture became cheap in slowly. Like all these things, basically there are different types of questions, and on those questions, basically they also have basically make the debates. The universal behavior manifestation, we people basically use the watches, television, its magazines, newspapers, all of these things. So our behavior must be changed through it. I think India's vulgarization. Vulgarization means, no, nowadays the culture has no art form, no body of knowledge, wisdom, vulgarization, etc. Like all those things. Then, valuable pair of millions. Valuable pair of millions mean, valuable pair of millions means, maximum people basically depends upon the industry. आप लोग बहुत सारे लोगों की रोजी रोटी इससे चलता है, इसीलिए ये वैल्यूएबल पेयर्स ऑफ मिलियंस. द मीडिया प्रोड्यूसर्स, द एक्टर्स, द जर्नलिस्ट, द डायरेक्टर, द स्क्रिप्ट राइटर एटसेट्रा. So many people are basically related to this industry. So this is the valuable pair. Okay, the pre-digest art for governor. It is very easily understandable and very digestible. Before to watch the programs, the common people are basically digested all these things. And they basically, because there is so superficial art materials to satisfy the mass of individuals. To make the profit, okay? Then drives and folk arts. The folk arts means the great art. Folk art means the great art. It the great art now basically escaped from the mass. Because mass culture homogeneously all culture debases the entire culture spectrum. The mass culture debases entire culture system spectrum means the baseless kori douchi dhire dhire. ଯଦି ବେସଲେସ୍ ଆମେ କରିଦଉଛି ଦେନ୍ ଆମେ କଣ କରିବା ମାସ୍ କଲଚର ସେଥିପାଇଁ ରୁଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ମାନେ ରୁଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଭ୍ରି କଲଚର ବେସିକାଲି ଇନ୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମରେ ସେସବୁ ମାନେ ସେଗୁଡ଼ାକ ଅଛି ବୋଲି ଆମେ ଜାଣିବା ଦରକାର. ଦେନ୍ କଭର୍ସ ୱାଇଡେଷ୍ଟ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ଏରିଆ. ଆମେ ଇ କଣ ହଉଛି ନା ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ଏରିଆ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ଏରିଆ ୱାଇଡେଷ୍ଟ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ଏରିଆ ବହୁତ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ସେ ଏକା ସାଙ୍ଗରେ ପହଞ୍ଚି ପାରୁଛି. ଦେନ୍ କରପ୍ସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେରିଲାଇଜ୍ ଦ ହେରିଟେଜ୍. ଆମର ଯୋଉ ସଂସ୍କୃତି ଅଛି, ଆମର ଯୋଉ ଚଳନୀ ଅଛି, ଆମର ଯାହା ବି ସେଗୁଡା ଅଛି ସେଇସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡାକ ଦେନ୍ ହାଇଲାଇଟ୍ ସେଗୁଡାକ କଣ ହଉଛି ତାକୁ କରପ୍ଟ କରିଦଉଛି, ଦେନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେରିଲାଇଜ୍ କରୁଛି, ତାକୁ ବାରମ୍ବାର ଚେଞ୍ଜ କରୁଛି, ତାକୁ କରପ୍ଟ କରୁଛି ଏଭ୍ରିଥିଙ୍ଗ. କରପ୍ସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଷ୍ଟେରିଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ହେରିଟେଜ୍ ଦ ପାଷ୍ଟ. ପୂର୍ବରୁ ଯୋଉ ଐତିହ୍ୟ ଗୁଡାକ ଆମର ରହିଛି ଏକ୍ଜାକ୍ଟଲି ଆମେ ଯଦି କହିବା ତାକୁ ଐତିହ୍ୟ ଗୁଡାକ ଅଛି ତାକୁ ଇଏ ତାକୁ ଚେଞ୍ଜ କରିଦଉଛି. ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଗ୍ରାଜୁଆଲି ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରଏଜ୍ ଦ ଫୋକ୍ କଲଚର ଅଲସୋ. ୟୁ ପିପୁଲ ଅଲସୋ ନୋ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଫୋକ୍ କଲଚର? ୟେସ୍, ଦ ଫୋକ୍ କଲଚର ଲାଇକ୍ ୟୋର ପାଲା, ଦାସକାଠିଆ, ଘୁଡ୍କି ନାଚ, ଚମ୍ପୁ, ଛାନ୍ଦ, ଡାଲଖାଇ, ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍. ଓଡ଼ିଶାର ମୁଁ ଏଗୁଡା ସବୁ କହିଲି କିଛି କିଛି ଜିନିଷ ଓଡ଼ିଶାର କିଛି ଇଏ ନା ହଁ ନା ଆମେ ତମକୁ ପଚାରିଥାନ୍ତି. ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ଆମର ବେସିକାଲି ସାଡ଼ ପୋପେଟ ତମର କଣ ଅଛି, ରାବଣ ଛାଇ ଯୋଉଟା ଅଛି ଏଇଟା ଆମର ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ, ଏଗୁଡା ସବୁ ବହୁତ ଭଲ ସଂସ୍କୃତି ଆମର ଏଠି, ସେଇସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡାକ ଆମର ଶିଖୁ. ଓ ନାଉ ଦୋଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍ ବେସିକାଲି ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ବି ଭାନିସ୍, ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରୋଜ୍ ଦ ଫୋକ୍ କଲଚର, ଦ ମାସ୍ କଲଚର ଗ୍ରାଜୁଆଲି ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରୋଜ୍ ଦ ଫୋକ୍ କଲଚର. ଓକେ, ଦେନ୍ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡ୍ ଗୁଡ୍ ଏସ୍ଥେଟିକ୍ ଆଉ କେନ୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦ କଲଚର ଡିବେଟ୍ ମେ ରିଲିଭାଣ୍ଟ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସେସ୍ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଦ କ୍ରିଟିକ୍ସ ଦୋଜ୍ ହୁ ଆର୍ଗ୍ୟୁ ଦଟ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଆରିଷ୍ଟୋକ୍ରାସି ଓରିଏଣ୍ଟେଡ୍ କଲଚର ଇଜ୍ ଭାଏବଲ୍ and those who condemn that there is a deep need for democratic culture. I think there are so many people, so many communication strategies, so many researchers, they basically research on these things in different way. But now still there is a little bit difference. It is because the culture is a complex thing. Exactly nobody gets some exact idea about the real thing of culture, okay, and the real changes in of culture. Okay, the folk culture has ceased to exist. Yes, the folk culture try to exist in the society now because the mass culture has taken its place. In the past, we people basically told that the folk culture is the popular culture. Now, the mass culture became the popular culture. So, the folk culture has ceased to exist. Then, mass culture exists and is determined to its content. Okay, the mass culture exists. Yes, so many people, we people basically in our houses also, you see and you also basically identify that many family members of us, they basically very interested. So watch the soap operas, the children are also very interested to watch the cartoon shows, etc., etc. They are not interested to know about the real culture, the real folk art form. I think the 11 years of son of me basically is not aware about the folk culture. Then like him, So the mass children also, they are also basically not aware. I think the standardization demanded by the media forces homogenization and mass culture content. The standardization demanded by the media forces homogenization into mass culture content means mass media must treat people as mass, no matter how stratified and culturally differentiated a society may be. The mass culture is essentially marketable. Yes, now the culture became a commodity. Now the culture sold by the producers to the audience. Yes, the merchants of mass cultures, the promoters, the businessmen, the commercial artists, they are basically sold the product to the audience, the customers. The mass culture is mediocre and vulgar. Yes, it is average. It is not high. It is vulgar also. The mass culture is immoral. There is no moral value. There is no ethical value. The mass culture is psychologically harmful. Yes, this is psychology harmful. If we can take the example of different types of crime stories have basically broadcast in the television programs. After you people basically watch again and again, there is something different will create in your mind. After watching the ghost film, then you also feel like that there is someone behind you. I think the psychologically also it is harmful. The mass culture is manipulative. The merchants of mass culture, basically, they change the concept. They basically change the subject, the concept, according to the needs of the people. Before 2 days, I watched a program of Mahabharata, an episode of Mahabharata. They basically fabricated, superficially present the program according to the needs of the people. Okay, then mass culture has filled the world of culture. Yes, the mass culture has filled the world of culture. Like there were two cultures in the past, like high culture and folk culture. Okay, the high culture and folk culture, now they basically try to exist. The high culture and the folk culture try to exist here after the mass media, after the mass culture entered in the market. So mass culture is not a culture. Yes, it is not a culture. Mass culture, it is alien to any kind of genuine culture. It also destroys the genuine culture alien. Mass culture is inherent to mass society. Yes, mass culture is inherent to mass society. Mass culture breaks down all barriers of class, tradition, and taste and eliminates all cultural distinction. It mixes and scrambles anything together and produce what may be called homogenized culture. Yes, then mass culture in India. I think Indian mass culture basically is in the form. Now we can say like that. It is also mostly influenced by the West. Not only India, the developing country all over the world basically influenced by the mass culture. Okay, then. I think we complete the second unit, then the third unit. It is already it. Okay. Then media as a cultural industry. Okay, media as a cultural industry. Global media scenario of mass media and intercultural communication, convergence of media culture. Okay, cultural industry. Yes. Now the world became a cultural industry. Books, journals, educational texts, then our videos, audios, and the films, sound recordings. All these things have became the product in the all of in the global media, and they are basically they basically made the cultural industry of the world. So there are so many book publishers in all over the world. About 80% of books and journals and educational texts basically published from the industrial countries. Okay, like if you people basically go to the film, like India make more and more films. India and Japan are basically the the most film makers of the world, but they basically try to maximum foreign filmmaker, they projected their film in the film fairs. But India is in very backward position in this case. In impediments in the global flow, I think there is some problems, there is some barriers in the global flow, like economic include such as books sold in abroad, shortage, foreign exchange, etc., etc. The postage, the customs, etc., transportation for the books and magazines, and those are the barriers now. International advertising, the United States remain the leader in the global promotion now. The culture, the world became the cultural industry. The international advertising also became large. Okay, then the world top 50 advertising agency in terms of gross income and billing includes the United States agencies, basically in the top, and some countries are also follow the United States. In also in video computer related technology, they are also flow in the market, and the film, the soap operas, they are also influenced by the by other countries. A control over content, yes, the global conglomerates, the big media houses, they basically control over the content. We people basically still now depend upon the Western countries and the developed countries for their the contents, and like the social implications, the most profound there, the social implications means the social implications of a future in which human communication increasing takes place through electronic media. Now, the world of mass media, there are some questions. What happens when the media cross national and cultural boundaries? Yes, what happens? There, we people have some questions in our mind. What role do the mass media play in our seeing and understanding the world? This question also arises in our mind. On what happens when Western television programs are imported into a non-Western context? Yes, there are so many questions arise in our mind, like the world of mass media now basically became expanded, and now the mass media reached to the digital era, and the technological advancement is also there, etc. The mass media and the cultural change, how the mass media changed the culture. Yes, the mass media changed the culture. The media creates awareness. Yes, the mass media create awareness. You can take the example of COVID-19 corona. And in this time, the government, basically through the media and also the private media houses, are basically spread the message, the awareness messages about COVID-19 corona. So the media creates awareness. It is right. The media sets agenda. Yes, the media sets agenda. Agenda setting can be achieved by giving prominence to certain people, events and places through media coverage. Yes, agenda settings is very important work of the media. Okay, the media promotes stereotypes. Yes, the media also promotes stereotypes like old age, sexuality, religion, war, parenthood, countless other aspects of human life also promoted by the media. Okay, there's no new things. The same thing also continue. Okay. And mass media and intercultural communication. See, mass media and intercultural communication. Yes, for intercultural communication, the mass media is a very great device. Okay, because the culture interrelate with others through the media. We people basically know about the other culture through the media. And we people basically know different culture, also follow the cultures through the media, etc. Then the political economy in the mass media. Yes, the political economy. What is the political economy? Political economy. Basically, the economy always basically control everything, I think. The politics and politics, without the base of politics, the economy will not change. You can also see different decisions of government. Anytime any party basically rule in your government, basically, but the political party, the ruling party always try to change the economic policy as per the circumstances, as per the profit, as per the basically the need of the society at that time. The political economy is a very important factor. How impact does this ownership and control have over media content and the broader society? Yes, the media society, the media ownership also basically controlled by the political parties. In Odisha, you also can identify the media house, maximum media houses basically owned by some renowned politicians. Why you people also know that? I think this is not the platform. I will discuss about that. Okay, then the homogeneity and heterogeneity of media content. There are two ways of conceptualizing the relationship between global and local media. Yes, then the what is homogeneity, the equality, and the heterogeneity. What is heterogeneity? It is the difference of culture. Okay, then the media effects on identity creation. Yes, the media always creates the identity. If you can take the example of Sarathi Baba, we people basically basically worshipped him as the Lord Vishnu, I think. Then after the media basically published the news about him, is basically his corruption, his relation with the crimes, related with crimes. After that, the identification of that fellow basically changed. Okay, then media also creates the identity. The procedure of media, the production of media culture. The media culture basically is very complex thing. The media culture basically produced by different producers. They basically try to change the different things. And the here is a point is gatekeeping. Yes, the gatekeeping is a metaphor to describe the process by which selection is made in media work. Yes, which news will go, which news will not go, etc., etc. I think the logic of media culture. Yes, the processing of media raw materials for the form of cultural narration. Then refers to the influence of media, the real world events themselves, as well as on their portrayal and confusion. Then basically media logic as the way of seeing and interpreting social affairs. Yes, the way of seeing and interpreting social, how you people basically perceive, how the media perceive those things, all those things basically. Then convergence of culture. Convergence means the mix of cultures, different cultures basically mix up, when it is called the convergence of culture. And I think people discuss about the whole the chapter in a little time. I think try to my best to touch everything. Okay, I think I have finished my job. Hello, sir.
Okay, madam. Let me summarize all these things.
Okay. Sir.
Then the student would write some question in the dashboard, or they can ask. I will give the chance.
Okay.
So the paper was regarding cultural studies, basically understanding culture. And what is culture? People have their own lifestyle, own living style, own dressing, food, own tradition, own culture. All culture means there are a lot of things include the culture, right? Marriages, behaving to people, dressing, fooding habits, a lot of things are there. So why we are reading this cultural studies in communication, or basically in mass media? Because when we are communicating to the people also, there is some impact of those cultures in those communication. And Madam has discussed elaborately about different cultures, how the culture is in India, in abroad, or in other areas, or where it is, sometimes it is regional, sometimes it is organizational culture, sometimes it is ethnic culture, sometimes subcultures. Culture is divided into the societies. Modernization means high bro culture, middle bro culture, low bro culture. Sometimes the culture is complex, sometimes it is interlinked with other culture. So I will give you a best example of interlinked with other culture. Today,
yes.
If I will ask to every nation, developing nation, do you know pizza? Then they will say, yes, we know pizza. There is Domino's pizza, there is McDonald's pizza. Somehow they will give the brand names of pizza companies. If I will go to some other countries, I will ask, do you know vada pav, or do you know samosa? What is that? That means we can able to understand that some other food culture is imposed in India or imposed in the rest of the countries. That means changing the food habit of different people. So these are the culture. So if we presently look after, we are imitating film actress, we are imitating film actor, we are imitating different brand dresses. That is the impact of culture. So next we have gone to the next unit, understanding popular culture. Yes, what is a popular culture? When we do have our own culture, and those each and every culture is one of the popular culture we do understand. Among them, today when presently media is playing a vital role of changing the culture. So we should want to know that how the media is able to change, or how the media is capable of making changes in the society of those aspects. Because we can see at every day evening at the prime time, when the news channel is looking after the religious aspects, or the political aspect, or the economic aspect, or presently we can tell COVID-19. So whatever we watch, whatever we see, or whatever the communication is done by the media, is basically known as the culture or the communication which is influenced by the media. So that is the reason we are mostly communicated in the way the media is going to communicate, and we accept it. We cannot make any changes.
Yes.
That we will not watch this particular channel, or whatever the media will give the information, that we have to, first day we will not believe. Second day we will not believe. Third day we will not believe. But at last, a certain period will come, it will influence us. Because we have gone through different model and different theory of mass communication. It perceives the people on its own way. So that is why we are reading media as a cultural industry, how the media is creating an impact on the society, what is the logic behind the media, what is the identity, how the media is creating identity of the people, because they are communicating on day-to-day basis. We don't know who is Sambit Patra, but we know Sambit Patra from the media, he is a spokesperson from BJP. We don't know Rahul Gandhi, then media tell that Rahul Gandhi is son of Sonia Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi. Then we come to know he is the president of Congress. We don't know Narendra Modi, media is giving that. Before 50 years, what happened when there was no media, people doesn't able to know who is our prime minister also. But today, a kid can able to know he is Narendra Modi, or a old man can able to blame that this is not the right prime minister, or so and so different aspect. Positivity and negativity is coming. So this is the impact of media, particularly in the way media is going to take you, and you are moving on that aspects. So I think the madam has given a clear cut, and in a hurry she has covered the block. Thank you, madam, because we have a tentative time period to complete the syllabus. We can complete the syllabus in four block into four classes. So here are some questions. I do understand we have SMS to the CJMC and DJMC student to come and join in this class, because we want to engage everyone. Particularly paper is for BJMC, but knowing the media, knowing the culture, knowing the media impact, knowing different aspects of media, the CJMC student and the DJMC student will be benefited to give the answers in the exams. So hopefully they are being invited on that basis. But the course is particularly for the BJM students. And madam, would you like to take some questions asked by the students?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I will
Okay. Is globalization affecting the influence? So is globalization affecting or influencing different cultures? Yes, he's asking a question whether the globalization is affecting or influencing the cultures. Yes, ma'am.
Already, sir, already discussed about the globalization also influence the mass and the people also and other cultures also. The advancement of the technology, we people basically reached everywhere of the world within some moment, and also everything also reached to us in within some moments. Then I think we know about the culture of others, and also the people culture know about the cultures of us. And I think our culture also influenced them. We can take also different examples, like at the time of Barack Obama, they also lightened the candle in their in White House at the time of Deepavali, I think.
Yes, ma'am.
So we people also now, and some foreigners also wear sarees, etc. I think the culture also influenced.
At a certain time, we are telling that we are influenced by Western cultures, but somehow each and every country do have some rich culture. Those rich culture have been followed by rest of the other culture. So definitely it is affected, and somehow it is affected, it is influenced also. So the question is, it is affected and influenced. And there
Yes.
is another question, ma'am. Many times we are making fun of other culture. How it is justified?
No, it is
By
not justified. No, it is not justified, because without knowing deeply about the other culture, we can basically satirized, because every culture have its own uniqueness and is its indigenous concept. So we people basically don't satirize or don't comment, don't criticize others' culture, I think.
yes. Maybe that particular culture is not accepted by me, but that culture is being accepted by most of the communities, most of the people, most of the public, or a country, or a state, or a small part of the region. So we should not discriminate, or we should not means comment on other culture. So that is our suggestion. Sarita Behra is writing, Madam, do journalists experience cultures shock as in reporting in the area that is completely different from the culture and cultural ethics? Any
Yes,
tips for overcoming culture shock? Okay.
yes. Sometimes we people, when we basically have don't have the knowledge about the culture of other countries, if the reporter sent to by the organization to there, then at that time he or she may basically face different types of problems, the cultural shock. Some tips, I think, before we go to the other country, we must learn about their culture deeply. That is the best thing, I think. That is the best thing to avoid the cultural shock in that area.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Again, RJ World, someone is writing, Madam, is it a correlation between media and culture? Yes,
Yes,
definitely.
they are basically mutually influenced. There is some relation between culture, because the communication is a part of culture. Okay, the communication and the without the communication, the culture can spread. So they are interrelated, and they are basically mutually interrelated, and they mutually influence each other.
I want to add something at here, madam. In
You
communist country,
can use
in communist country, the communist government want to impose one strict word to the public. But in India,
Yes.
is a democratic country. Here, the culture is something different. What majority of the people is saying, The media is focusing on that aspect, where the
Yes.
less majority is not satisfied, media is not going on that. But in some other republic country or the American, where the president word is final, so the democratic process of culture is not been influenced at that. This is what we can tell that how there is a influence of culture in different countries.
हेलो हाँ अगेन अगेन यू कैन आस्क द क्वेश्चन
यस मैम.
हाँ अगेन यू कैन
हाँ
आस्क द क्वेश्चन
अगेन.
सर
हाँ ओके. रोल ऑफ मीडिया इन शेपिंग ए कल्चर एंड वाइस वर्सा. यस, व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ मीडिया इन शेपिंग कल्चर, रोल ऑफ मास मीडिया
रोल
इन
ऑफ
शेपिंग ए कल्चर एंड वाइस वर्सा.
रोल ऑफ द मीडिया इज सेटिंग द कल्चर एंड वाइस वर्सा इट इज राइट बिकॉज द कल्चर अफेयर्स द कल्चर थ्रू द मीडिया द कल्चर स्प्रेड्स टू अदर टू द ऑडियंस टू द कंज्यूमर्स एंड थ्रू द एंड द कल्चर बेसिकली केम थ्रू द मीडिया द कल्चर एंड मीडिया दे आर बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू विथ ईच अदर बेसिकली द कल्चर एंड मीडिया Both are interrelated. Before some times, I already have said.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. There is a question from Sushil Kumar Jain. How the mass media is diluting our old culture and trying to give high value to the Western culture, and how we could overcome from it?
How the mass media is?
Diluting our old culture and
Yes.
trying to give high value to the Western culture, and how we could overcome from it?
Yes. Now you can take some examples. Now you see the eating habits, your fooding style, and your dressing sense, and your living styles also change, and it basically influence and influence and affect by the Western world, and you get over it. Change is always acceptable. I think change is always acceptable. And if there is vulgarity, then you should change it. And I think we people basically try to know our culture, try to learn about our culture, try to basically go to the deep root level, the root to our culture, so we people can change the culture. Sir, Radna, one phone call is I can
Okay,
take
I
it.
will take the, I'm taking. I'm taking.
Yes,
So there is a question from a student that how is Western culture is dominating? You see, when our media person is there, they are always focusing on our own culture. Every country focus on their own culture. But it is true that some advertisement, some public relation, some how the behavior of the media person ultimately influence. But I still believe that in every puja, in every occasion of Holi and Deepavali, Ramzan, and so Christmas, the media person celebrate inside the media house. I don't think so. The Westernization is dominating the Indian culture, or the Western culture or the American culture is being dominated by the Indian culture. Is each and everyone have its own place in customs. So it is somehow we are addicted with Western cultures. Then I think Prasad Mohanty is asking several questions. Can he come verbally and ask question? Prasad Mohanty, you can unmute and ask question. I think madam has given homogeneity and heterogeneity, and then you do have written something I cannot understand properly. Can you? Hello, Prasad. Okay, anyone want to put his question? Anyone? Okay, Abhijit.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, this is Abhijit. Okay,
yes.
Please, please, on, carry on.
Yeah. Do you have any question? So, I think there is no question from anyone else. Here I want to tell everyone, this people are asking about the examination. Examination, government has stopped that we should not conduct any examination till June 17. After June 17, we will have the examination. But before that, we will have a notification in the website. So don't be panic. This is the right time. You do have enough time to read. You go through the SLM. Those who have not received the hard copy of SLM, that means the books, they can go through the soft copy available in our website. And again, I'm telling, whatever the classes information are going to you, all people, so you come and join. You come and attend the classes because it will clear your doubts. So if you get time, enough time you're getting inside the home, so you read all these SLMs, have questions, note it on. So in the respective classes, you can ask the question to the faculty members. Okay. But it should not be relevant. It should not be irrelevant questions. It should be relevant. So, it's my suggestion. I think madam is not coming back. So, we would like to stop right now. Is
sir,
there any question from any? How, Abhijit?
Sir, this is Abhijit Patnaik this time. So, my suggestion is just if the classes are more interactive, then it will be helpful for us.
Yes.
It is.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, you're asking about the classes would be more interactive. Actually, what happened? This is not a classroom. This is a virtual classroom. So students are far away from us. We don't know when who will ask the question. So after the lecture is complete, if somebody is asking a question, then that can be answerable. Otherwise, ultimately, the resource person will not have a flow of giving lectures. Or he or she could not able to cover your topic in a flow. That's why we are giving enough time. We are giving half an hour after the class is over. Okay. So you come with a notepad and a pen. Whenever you cannot understand, write the question. After the class is going to end, we are giving the time. At least after 1 hour, we are giving the time to write the question in the dashboard. You can write the question, or else verbally we are giving the chances. You can come verbally and ask the question also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay. Anyone else want to ask any question? Madam has come back. Kisi question nahi karo? So we will end the session.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. Yes.
Hello.
Swasti. Pani grahi.
Sir, actually, more to later join kali. More message to be later dekhi chhi sir. Actually, the timing was I means 3:30 thilana sir.
Yes.
Sorry for late joining, but just I want to know the chapter and what is the topic about.
Yes, you're from DJMS.
Related to communication or editing or as actually I got 11 books there.
You're related to CJMC or DJMC?
DJMC.
You're DJMC. Actually, this is the whole subject is all about BJMC, bachelor degree. But
yes,
if the topic is related to mass media, so we have thought that CJMC and DJMC, till the classes are not been conducted, these students should be invited. So I have kept all those
so
CJMC and DJMC.
It's knowledge about overall of communication, media, editing.
Yes. It's all about the knowledge about culture, media. Okay.
Thank you.
So we have invited all of you. Okay. Okay. Anyone want to ask question? I think there is no question, so we can stop the class right now.
Yes, sir. At last, I would like to thank the students to attending the classes, and thank you, Madam Soumya Madam, for taking my call. And with a short notice, we have invited you to take the classes and agree to take the classes. In this situation, we are right now interacting almost every students from master degree to bachelor degree. So, Madam, again and again, I thank on behalf of the students, on behalf of OSU, and thank you. So, I would like to thank you, thank you. I would like to thank you to the technical team, Abhinandan, as well as Sumita ma'am, who is looking at the technical aspects. Without them, we cannot able to sustain, because there are a lot of barriers which come in between the session. So let us end now at here. Thank you everyone.
Thanks, sir, to give the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks, ma'am.
Thank you. Some students are complaining basically why ma'am basically have not in the video. If I will take the next class, I will come with the video. Okay, thank you.
That's a loss of bandwidth actually.
Okay.
That's thank you. A lot of bandwidth. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.